Hey, what's going on, everybody? Welcome in. I'm Joey. Jumping right into some S-Class action in the GT40 here as I'm all over the bumper of this Lambo. And I'm not being the most respectful driver here as I'm going directly into his backside again. And he's going to show me directly to where the tire wall is. Now, come on. I feel like I didn't really deserve that. It's not like I was fornicating with his backside. Oh, shield the children's eyes. I was making sweet, sweet love to the back of that Lambo. And just a couple turns down the hill, I can't believe my eyes. It's my new Lambo girlfriend letting another dude in a BRZ up her tailpipe. And I'm not having that. I'm gonna go straight up to this guy in the BRZ, take an inside line and tap him just to let him know to stay away from my girl. Skipping forward to lap three here, I've got fourth and third place in my sights, so a podium is totally within question, and honestly, I'm really liking my chances here. Everything is just so easy in the GT40. The Porsche is going to go a little wide there, and I'm just going to slot up the inside. The handling on this thing is so unbelievable, and now I've got a chance to go chase down this new evolution of the GT40 here. Who's gonna get me a little out of shape. I'm gonna swerve to the left to avoid him, but he's gonna go wide too, and I'm gonna slot up right into third place, and that's gonna be where I'm gonna finish. So I made a pretty good recovery, albeit with like seven people in the lobby, but for those of you that have watched my other videos, you know I'm not passing up the opportunity for a shoey. Moving on to Yas Marina, and I hope you're ready for a nice clean race, because this is not it. Turn one here is always a total disaster. I'm gonna act like this guy's makeshift fucking backboard, and he's not done yet. He's gonna try to slot up the inside of these two guys. He's just creating absolute mayhem. And then on this long sweeping right, he's gonna go wide. I'm gonna take a nice line, and let's go and pause it right there, because at this point, there's like two things that could be going through his mind. He could slow down and rejoin then, or he could just be thinking absolute death, rejoin now, and just take me out. And I guess there could be a third thing he's thinking about. I just can't stop thinking about it. But anyways, let's see what he ends up doing. And yep, you guessed it. He's gonna rejoin now. He's gonna take me out, and I'm going to go straight into the wall. It was absolute murder, pure assassination in cold blood. I'm down to 15th place, my race is over. But I did manage to regain a little bit of my pride and finished in 8th. Alright, hopping over to Road Atlanta for another race or not. Maybe I'll just get taken out right at the beginning. I mean, no one wants to watch actual racing, right? That's not why you're here. Forza clearly doesn't care what you want and doesn't care what I want either, because I finally caught up to the dude that took me out. And look at this, he's gonna hit the barrier, I'm gonna hit him in the exact same place that he took me out at the start. I mean, I can't write this stuff. Forza is just an absolute trove of content, seriously. So by the end of the race, it's gonna be another 8th place. And you know what, I wouldn't have it any differently. Now, at this point, I decided to make a change. Clearly, there was some bad juju going on with that GT40 that had nothing to do with lack of talent at all. So I figured I'll go a different direction. I'll hop in the F50 for a race, see if I can reverse some of this bad juju and maybe actually put a clean race in. And I had my hopes up for this race because I've been running a lot of rivals recently, specifically with the F50 at Watkins Glen. So my hopes were up. I really thought that I could get a pretty solid race in here, even though you wouldn't be able to tell because I obviously just hit the wall there. But this Ferrari is actually really similar to the GT40 in a lot of ways. It's just got a little more speed and a little less handling, which is pretty much perfect for Watkins Glen. You've got some pretty long straights that can really take advantage of that. I'm actually going to close in on this GT40 here on this straight and have a look up the inside. And he's going to see me right at the last minute, and he's kind of going to peel off to the side, maybe like a little nervous reflex there, but we slot up into fifth and we take that position. Now, all of a sudden, there's a massive roadblock in front of me, and I'm gonna go straight into this GT40, get stuck on him. He's gonna go on top of me, I'm gonna hit the wall, I'm gonna get hit by another GT40, another one, and then this McLaren's gonna come in and take me out. I don't even know what happened. I'm dazed and confused. I think I got hit by like five or six guys there. So yeah, it was five different cars and I somehow managed to collect myself and keep going here, but then I see the poor GT40 who is clearly just in shock over what just happened. Oh, come on. Like you didn't expect me to play Marvin Gaye again. There's just been so much lovemaking in this episode. I think I might just start posting these videos to adult film websites and see how they do over there. So maybe next week, check out your favorite websites and I guarantee you the F50 is going to be the top trending actor over there for sure. As I'm up the inside of that McLaren there and take ninth place, can we just have some real talk here for a second? Like, who wouldn't want to see the baby of an F50 and a GT40? I mean, that's like Ford versus Ferrari coming together to create like a Le Mans god. Like, I think that'd be pretty damn cool. As we take those long sweeping left and rights pretty well, actually. And here's where the Ferrari really shines on the straight, absolutely overtaking that guy like a boss. And we're going to finish this one in 7th place. So, hey, it's at least not 8th. And last but not least, over to Hockenheim. Now, the first few races of this video have been all about lovemaking. And sometimes with love, it crashes and burns and you want revenge. And that's kind of what this one's going to be all about. So I'm back in the GT40. The experiment with the F50 clearly didn't work out any better than the races before. So I figured I'll hop back in the GT40 and see if I can change things around. Obviously, that's not going to happen. It's Forza. We know how this whole charade goes. But for now, we're heading down the Parabolica and I'm just going to miss my braking point. I'm going to go into the back of this BMW here. And I'm going to extend my line out a little bit to get a better run. And, well, he's going to end up braking for this turn here, which you really don't have to brake for. And he's going to take exception to that. He's going to back off, actually, and then absolutely pile drive me into the barrier. And I'm just going to get stuck there like a dart in a dartboard for a second. So now I'm pissed off. You know, I gave him a couple love taps, but nothing that totally ruined his race. And he just pile drives me into the wall. So I'm angry. I want my revenge now. And nothing is going to stop me. I'm going to track extend. I'm going to cut corners. I'm going to catch this guy. So I've got to settle in here, focus on hitting my braking points and setting some really solid lap times. But as we're heading into the final section of the track here, that's gonna prove a little difficult as this guy's gonna rejoin across the track. And his buddy over here, who probably just got into it with him, cuts literally half the track and is just a massive advertisement for a lawn mowing simulator. Like, I don't know what this guy is thinking. But anyways, that's gonna complete lap one in pretty dramatic fashion. But we've still got 3 laps to go, and I don't see our target in range yet. And honestly, I don't even remember what his gamer tag was, so I'm kind of just going blindly until we find him, and then I guess deciding what to do from there. But coming onto the Parabolica now, 3 wide through this turn, the Audi is just going to give me enough space to squeak through as the Porsche went wide, and somehow I got through there without a scratch. Yeah, that Audi was really kind, gave me just enough space to kind of make that move possible. And now I can focus on, well, my favorite position of the episode, I guess, and that's 8th place. Fast forwarding a bit to turn 11, which is really tricky to make work. This guy is going to go totally wide and just totally forget to brake, but I'm going to be focused on him, and I'm going to go wide too, straight into the sand, And now I'm just totally worried. Like, am I going to catch up to this guy? Will I be able to get my revenge? It's all totally up in the air now. But I guess I didn't really lose too much time. I didn't go nearly as deep as that other guy did. So there's definitely still a chance. Skipping forward to the final lap now. I was finally able to catch up to this group in front of me. And I totally missed my braking point again because I spotted the guy who knocked me off into the wall. Now my blood's running hot. I know I'm gonna have a chance here if I can hit all my turns right at getting this guy back. Now, obviously the elephant in the room here is this Ferrari that's sitting between us. So I know we're coming up on the last few turns here. If I'm gonna make a move, I need to make it now. So I'm gonna extend my line off the track, cut it a little bit, but you know, it's for the greater cause. So now we're coming up on this little straight here, and I've got my target in sight. Line up the crosshairs and... So it turns out that was actually a really, really weak hit, and I'm hoping that totally real Forza gameplay makes it look a lot bigger than it was. But hey, it doesn't matter because I got my revenge, I got the hit, I got my position, and I'm gonna go on and count this one as a win. But that's gonna do it for this video, guys. Thank you as always for watching. Come on back next week for a new episode, and I will see you then. Bye, everybody.